Good morning, this is Dr. Bill White with the American Orthodontic Society, and I would like to talk with you this morning just a little bit about using this bonded acrylic to judge the correct height of the lower third of the face. Now this lady that I'll show you here, I had worn her upper front teeth down considerably far, just grinding them off, and she had no posterior teeth, so the posterior teeth had just kind of migrated down lower, and it was in a big mess. And this type of thing requires you working very closely with some restorative guy. And of course the gentleman that sent the patient to me was a good restorative dentist, and he and I worked together very closely to try to correct as much as we could in this lady's problem that she had. Now she didn't have enough money to go through the whole thing, so we got the necessary things done, we felt like, and then waited on some of the other parts. So I don't show you the actual finished thing, but you can get a pretty good idea of what we were planning to do here. This is the lady, and you can tell right off, I mean, this vertical height of the face is just too low right here. I mean, the upper lip is quite short, and the chin is just too close to the nose. Of course, she doesn't have a great deal of space up here either, but we're going to try to build this up and give her a little more upper lip space. You can kind of see how we tried to do this. Now, when you look at it from the front, she's got her eyes closed here, but you can see the angle is too low. I mean, this distance, it needs to be down about here somewhere. And we'll try to lengthen that a little bit in doing this restorative work. And so you need to work real close with somebody. It's kind of a team thing, and sometimes you need an old surgeon and a restorative person, and then somebody that does the orthodontic part. Unless the guy doing the orthodontics is pretty good in restorative dentistry, it's certainly better to get bring somebody else in with it. Of course, this was this gentleman's patient. He sent her to me to see what we could do, and so here is the dentition, and you can see where this is worn off considerably here, and had no posterior teeth down here, so these teeth have erupted down, and both sides, so the mouth has dropped down about 3 to 4 millimeters lower on the side. So we're going to come back and try to build this part up on these front teeth. You can take this acrylic, but first we needed to close the space and do some orthodontics in here and get that lined up and bring these front teeth back over the lower teeth to some extent. We didn't try to get everything just perfect. It would be very difficult. And this is what I'm saying. There's so much adult orthodontics out there that there's no way that we can do all of it. Now, this lady kind of ran out of money before she could crown all these teeth and do everything, but we did get the gentleman made a lower kind of a partial for us, and then he crowned some of the teeth on the right side of the mouth over here. And then we had left part of it there to finish up and force the crowns on these teeth up here. We're not finished. Of course, that hadn't even been done at all when we finish the work we were in, into. And so there are a lot of cases like that, that you have to do the most important things that have to be done that will get worse if you leave them alone. And then some of them you can leave there for a few months, some you can leave longer than that, and then the person can kind of take care of the payment of this as they go along. So that way, or else borrow the whole thing to start with, and it's getting terribly expensive to do some of this work. Like if you put all implants back in the back of this lady's mouth, I mean, you can spend thousands and thousands of dollars getting something done. Now, back when we did this in the early 90s, I forget exactly, but it was a lot cheaper then than it is now, and it wasn't cheap then. So anyway, let's take a look at what we do here. Now, on the bottom, everything's lined up pretty good, and she was chewing on just, let me go back here, just actually chewing on these teeth down in here. I think my little red marking pen is gone out again on me. Let me get it back up there. So the occlusion was kind of keeping these teeth down, you see. And some of these back here had come up a little bit. They didn't have any contact. To do this right, it would have been good to take these tori and take them off, but he built a lower kind of partial that I could work with here. And we put braces on, and of course, brought this together, and then we put this bonding material on those and kind of carved teeth into it. And here you can see it. We're into the treatment some. Now the dentist made her a lower partial that I could work with, and then we lined this up, pulled this together. That brought these teeth back over the lower teeth to some extent, and we just shaped this acrylic up and had her bite into it from the back side, and you can see what where these lower anterior teeth are being, they'll be contacting this somewhere up in this depth back here. I'll show that to you from the, just looking in a mirror on the upper teeth, and here in just a minute. And you see how these teeth had gone down, so we opened this up and got these about the same level in here, and then they were able to put this lower partial in that way. It's a real challenge to do stuff like this. I could not intrude these. Now back in 95, we did very little, or I don't think any, where you put these little screws in the bone or tads and put springs or elastics on them and can lift these teeth up, you know. Of course, you won't want to lift them too high. You want to bring these teeth back down to their normal height, and so you're going to open the bite, you know, that much in doing that. This type of orthodontics is really challenging, I tell you. You wish you had some an implant or something back in here. Yeah, we could put pressure on these, but we put this partial in, and you're working off of this bone structure and tissue down here, and you can't put much pressure or you'll break this out or create problems here. So it becomes a kind of a problem getting this up. Now that we have these tads, that's going to help a lot. You can put them in on the buccal and up in the lingual and bond, you know, have your archway and you pick this whole thing up to some extent with them without putting a lot of pressure on this. Now, if you had tough tissue down here, you could keep building it up and you could push them up with that too. I've done some of that over the years. All right, we bonded that on and we changed the direction of it so you can see it. Obviously, it doesn't look as much like teeth, but now we've got this lined up down on the bottom. See, pretty much the same, and we'll see what I was working with him, and he did went his own way sometimes. That's the way it was ground down, and here we bonded this back. Now this is going to increase the whole lower third of the face, the height of it, by about this much, you see, and it'll give her a little more upper lip area in there. And looking at it from that side, now here is where we put this light cured acrylic in, and then you put a little Vaseline on your teeth and you close in here, and when you get to the height you want, you stop, and then you harden this with your light, and this will stay where they chew against it right here until they get some crowns made for these teeth. And then we like to have a kind of a gold shift, kind of like this one video we did here restoring a Brux's case. You know, case is really bad, and I'll show you the back side. You leave a shelf back here for the lower teeth to fit against, and it needs to be out of just straight gold. If you put porcelain back there, it grinds the enamel down in here. Now she came in and was able to crown these, but these we had to wait on, and I'll show you that we were unable to completely finish the case from just start to finish. We had to wait on there. So now this is the lower partial end, and you see we've got this lined up. We did orthodontics on that, and then this is this partial that she put in, he put in. And now this is another view. All right, you look at the facial structure. Now, this height is more than it is here. So we have increased this height about 3 or 4 millimeters in here, and makes it look better. It's not going to be perfect, but it beats what we had to start with. And we were able to put this acrylic teeth, you see, and then you judge that by the way she talks. And if these clack together, you got them too long, you know. And this looks pretty normal, and she talks and eats and does everything fairly normal with that. So when you build the permanent crowns and everything on the front of the mouth, you can get them at the right height, and that's what we're shooting for here. And you can see the side view of the facial structure is much better at that height. So we're going to use that. Now we come back, and these teeth we were unable to crown, or she ran out of money or something, but it won't hurt for her to wait for another several months or a year or something to come in and crown this these teeth. And she's going to want to crown all these front teeth. So it's an expensive ball game here. Now this right side of the mouth, she did come back and crown that. Let me see. I thought we had a picture. There it is. So these teeth were crowned, and it fits in. This cuspid looks a little high, but it's probably works out pretty good. He did this, and I just worked with him, and now we finish at this point. We were unable. rest of it. So there's a lot of orthodontics that you do this way. You do just one part over here, and then you do another part, and you come back. But you pick the things that are urgent, do them first, and then you can do these other things along the way. And just so that everything is focused toward a finish over here where you're going to have something good when you get through with it. So that's kind of something you work at. And you need to work with people to do this. So there's the upper, and of course he's chewing or eating on this part. These teeth right here probably drop down, and they'll come back and put some nice crowns on that. But they make a way to crown these front teeth first. This is as far as I got with the case. And the gentleman that referred her could do the rest of it, really, and I guess he did. I don't recall doing any more work on the lady. Okay, I'm sorry, that's the last picture I've got on. I hope you gained something out of this, and thanks for watching, and I'd love for you to sign up with our group and subscribe to my channel. So thank you very much, and I'm going to close out here.